in a different way. And that is to shape the future, because I believe the future of our nation is hanging in the balance over the next 4 to 5 years. Not just with the election, but I believe in the next 4 to 5 years. And I'm not trying to prophesy that, okay? I'm just saying my own opinion. I believe that what the next 80 to 100 years of America's history, if Jesus doesn't come before then, are going to be set in the next few years. And you and I are called to be champions, to help set the pattern and the temperature of what's going to happen in our nation and to the nations of the earth. But guys, sometimes we say, hey man, all that stuff, America and the world, the nations, Israel, that's great, but you know what? I'm barely surviving personally. Have you ever felt like that when a preacher's talking about all these big issues and you're like, man, that's great, but I'm just holding on for dear life? I want you to know something. God's not just concerned about the nation. He's concerned about you. Jesus didn't die for nations. He died for people. He loves you individually and personally. You know what? Maybe things are going on in your life that you need God to come and shake the power of the enemy off of your life. The attack of the enemy has been ferocious, relentless. But God is more relentless than the devil. And we're going to pray that he today would arise as the God of angel armies. That he will arise on your behalf. One of the things I love to pray for people is let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Would you stand to your feet with us, please? Kim, would you kind of come join me for a moment if you would? Guys, thank you for your indulgence of time. We want to take a few moments in this morning service as we just push past noon, and we want to respond corporately, but also individually to the challenge of the Lord to be shaken out of yesterday, be shaken out of our bondage, and to begin to move into freedom. You know, again, Shekinah was saying this, that sometimes deliverance is worship. Deliverance is not just, you know, some big, you know, spiritual warfare battle. Sometimes deliverance is God changing our mind and us following the mind of God. But we sang that God sets us free. We were lifting our hands about being free in his presence. We're going to ask God to bring freedom in our lives. So, Lord, we thank you that God, you are on the move. Even though we look and see around us darkness on the nation's gross darkness on the people, Lord, we are astounded. We are sickened. We are angered. Lord, at the things going on around us, we don't understand the demonic idiocy and lunacy and debauchery and deception that is taking a hold of the nations of the earth. God, we look and see Psalm 2, where the heathen rage, the kings of the nations, the leaders of culture, Lord, are raging against the Almighty God, trying to break the bands of what they consider bondage. But Lord, it's the grace of God that is sustained, that we are not already destroyed. But God, we live in a time of immense battle in the spiritual realm, breaking out, Lord, into seemingly civil war in so many aspects of culture. But God, we pray that we would not put our faith and our focus on the battle around us, but on the one who's already won the battle. For Jesus, you conquered death, hell, and the grave. You took the keys of authority back from Satan, and you've given them to your ecclesia, your church. So, Lord, shake us out of our fear. Shake us out of our cowardice. Shake us, oh God, away from everything that we've put our trust in for the future other than Jesus. God, we're concerned about the election. We're concerned about our economy. We're concerned about our educational system. But God, our faith is not in what happens in those realms of society. Our faith is in you, Jesus. So, Lord, shake us with your spirit. Fill us afresh. God, individually and corporately, that we would be empowered to speak the name of Jesus in a culture that's becoming violently angry against the name of Jesus and the gospel and the church. Lord, shift our mindsets. God, forgive us for thinking the ways of the world, for letting news broadcasts and Hollywood and the internet and cultural things set the way we believe. Lord, may we shift back to biblical thinking. And God, would you empower us to step ahead in our sphere of influence and lead the way? Lord, we pray for Crossroads Church. Lord, for Pastor Tim and Debbie. Lord, as we've gotten to know them through the years, Lord, they are a man and woman of God. And Lord, while we're standing and continuing to believe for the miracle of God healing-wise, God, we pray for them ministry-wise. Lord, we pray that you unfold the strategy of tomorrow. God, that you begin to let them see it is a different season. And Lord, it's not that they're blind to it. But God, we pray that you would help them lead us as a church into tomorrow. God, that we as a church will not just hold on to the methodology of yesterday. In fact, God, would you convict us as a church? Crossroads Church, God, would you convict us for staying in the past? You don't change. Your word doesn't change. But God, we've gotten stuck in yesterday's blessing that's now become today's bondage. Yesterday's revival has now become today's religion. So God, we repent for getting stuck in yesterday. Shake us out of our complacency. Shake us out of our comfort. Amos chapter 6 verse 1 says, "Woe to those who've gotten comfortable in the house of God." Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are our comforter when we need comfort. But may we never grow comfortable. Stir us, oh God, as a church. And Lord, for every individual that's fighting a personal battle, every individual, God, that feels like everything around them is shaking and they're saying, "God, where are you? I need you to come and rescue me." And all around me is sinking, saying, "On Christ the solid rock I stand." God, there are those among us, our brothers and sisters, your sons and daughters who you love. Lord, they're going through shaking. They're going through things that make no sense. God, they don't know what tomorrow holds, but they can know who holds tomorrow. So, Lord, we pray by your grace and your love and your mercy, would you reach down your mighty hand and rescue your sons and daughters. Deliver, heal. Lord, turn things around. So, God, we pray that, Lord, we would step ahead and lead the way, that Cameron, that Missouri, that America, that our families, our schools, our places of business, Lord, we begin to shift and change because we will not stay in the background any longer. We don't have to be loudmouth preachers like Tim and me. But God, you called everyone in this place to be an example, to be a light, to shine Jesus. So, Lord, we pray for that empowering of the Spirit. Just take a moment in the presence of God. We're not going to prolong things needlessly. But Holy Spirit, come. Heads bowed, eyes closed just for a quick moment. Guys, the first radical change that ever happens in a person's life is when they have a life-altering encounter with the Son of God, with Jesus. For some people, it happens as children. For me, I was about 5 years old, raised in church. I heard the story of Jesus. You know, probably the worst sin I'd ever committed at that point was stealing an Oreo cookie or something. I was not a bad child. I was not a brat. I was not some teenage delinquent. I was not some adult, deep in sin away from God. I was a, seemingly innocent child, but like all humanity, because of Adam's fall, I was born into sin. As a five-year-old, I needed forgiveness. And see, it wasn't because I'd lived a bad life, but I still needed a Savior. Some of you may be here today and you say, you know, even as an adult, you say, hey, I haven't lived a bad life and I haven't hurt people and, I'm a pretty good person. Guys, it's not our goodness that makes us acceptable before God. The Bible says the best that we can do, the best of our goodness is like filthy rags before a holy God. But God made the way through Jesus. And so maybe you're here today and you've been a good person, but you've never really come to a place of repentance and a life-changing encounter with Jesus. Or look, maybe you're a bad dude, a bad woman. You've lived in sin. You've all these other things. Like, how can God love me? How can God forgive me? I've spit in His face. I've just broken every law, every commandment. But can I tell you something? No matter how bad and sinful you've been, Jesus died for you. His love reaches out to you. He transforms lives. So the heads bowed, eyes closed just for a moment. Today, if you're here and you say, I need that life-transforming encounter with Jesus. I've never surrendered my life to Christ. I'm not just saying you're a Christian that's having some struggles. God won't strengthen you. I'm saying today you're here and you've never surrendered your life to Christ, or maybe you did, but you fully have backslidden. I'm not just saying you're having some troubles. You've walked away from God. And you say, today I'm coming to my senses like the prodigal son, and I'm coming back to Father's home. It would be our honor to pray with you. If you're here today and you need to surrender your life to Christ or you need to come back to the Lord, just lift a hand very quickly up in the air. Is anyone here like that? Thank you. Anyone else? And how many of you today would say, I want to freshly surrender every part of my life? I'm a believer. I'm on my way to heaven, but in the days ahead, I don't want to be found on the sideline. I want to be fully surrendered. How many of you, that's your heart? Would you lift your heads to the Lord and your hands? Would you just say this with me? We know words aren't magic, but would you just say, Jesus, thank you for loving me. You died on the cross for my sin to pay the penalty, because my sin deserves punishment and death. But Jesus, you took that punishment because you love me. And then you rose from the dead. So I can live. Not just in eternity. But now. I can have the life of God in me. So Lord, I confess that I've sinned. I repent. I turn away from my sin. I surrender my life to you, Jesus. I will follow you. Empower me by your Holy Spirit to live the life of Jesus and to tell people about you. So God, as we lift our hands, we thank you, Lord, for the one, maybe others, and then all of us, Lord, that have made a fresh surrender, come back to you. Our Lord, just saying, here we are, God, more surrender to you. And so, God, we pray that as we walk through today, as we make a fresh surrender, Lord, as we recognize the time that we are in, Lord, the time now is not to duck our head, hide away, and just wait to be rescued out of here, waiting for the rapture. We look forward to the return of Jesus. Lord, to those that look for you, you'll appear the second time without sin to salvation. So, Lord, we look forward. We say, Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. But until you come, we're not going to hide. We're not just going to go through the motions of church. We're not just going to try to protect our family from the world. But Lord, we are going to arise as the warriors of the Lord. We're going to arise as the body of Christ. We're going to arise as the army of God. Lord, you told us to occupy until you come. And so, Lord, we declare that Cameron, that our families, our places of influence, Lord, are going to be inundated. For Lord, your word says the kingdom of heaven is right at hand. Lord, there's about to be an invasion of the Holy Spirit. And so, God, we yield ourselves and dedicate ourselves. We will be the frontline army of God. We will have a revelation of Jesus. And God, our main message will not be political or cultural. Lord, our main message will be Jesus. Our main message will not be esoteric eclipses and trying to figure out whether 9/11 or the Baltimore Bridge was an inside job. God, that is not our main message. That's not our main focus. Lord, our main focus is Jesus. And so, Lord, may you fill the revelation of our spirit with the revelation of the Son of God. And, Lord, we thank you that, God, individually and corporately, we are about to move out of putting out Satan's fires, and we're going to lead the way. We want to pray that over you individually. We're going to tonight take time to pray personally, to lay hands, speak prophetically individually if God gives something. But would you with me lift your hands to the Lord? And God, we pray that, Lord, now every device and scheme and plan and agenda and strategy of the enemy, Lord, would be broken from off of the lives of the people of God. For, Lord, you said no weapon formed against us will prosper. Jesus, may you arise. And, Lord, as the mighty man of war, arise, O God. Jehovah Nissi, the Lord our banner, go before us, O God, and do battle. And, Lord, every area where even personally, it seems like some of us, we spend so much time trying to beat down the enemy's attack. The enemy attacks here. And so we're praying, we're fighting to put the enemy out. And then the enemy attacks there. The enemy attacks in our finances. The enemy attacks in our family. The enemy attacks in our health. And we're running around trying to put out the enemy's fires. But God, may we not just run around trying to survive, but may we go from surviving to thriving. May we go from, Lord, just getting by and making it, Lord, to going forward and taking territory. So, Lord, thank you. You are the God of victory who always causes us to triumph. And so, Lord, we declare that over Crossroads. We declare that over every individual life. And, Lord, we give you praise and we give you honor in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
I just have one healing word of knowledge. The Lord just keeps showing me. It looks like an organ I am seeing. I'm thinking I'm seeing a liver, but I'm not sure. I'm not a medical person, but I see there's a yellowish tint to it. And I see God's hand reaching down and taking away that infection or whatever that is and just giving you just brand new life in that organ. But I believe God wants to even bring a newness of life of that organ that I am seeing that has just that little bit of a yellowish tint to it.
If you need healing in your body, would you lift a hand? Any healing in your body, just lift a hand to the Lord. If you need healing in the liver or you have a family member need healing in the liver, wave. Is there anybody that describes? Okay, back over in here. Father, we thank you. Kim Shekinah, can you just go back and to our brother right there and just lay hands? Would you all just lift your hands to the Lord? Father, we thank you. Lord, as you are identifying, Lord, by your spirit specific, Lord, we declare healing, Lord, to the liver. It's Lord, right now we just declare, would you with me press into the Lord, congregation? God, we stand and we declare to the liver to be made whole. Anything that's attacking, any disease, anything that's not working properly, we say in Jesus' name, you are subject to the authority of the name of Jesus. We say to the liver, be made whole, to every attack, be driven away in Jesus' name. And God, for the rest, Lord, that need healing in some dimension of our body, as we are contending for Pastor Debbie, Lord, may she be a first fruit. May she be, Lord, Lord, that one that receives healing. But God, may there be an outbreak of healing. God, an outbreak of miracles. God, not tied to just one particular preacher or one particular service, but God, that you by your spirit would arise. And we declare that the attack of the enemy against us physically is defeated because Jesus took the stripes on his body for our healing. So Lord, release healing, release deliverance, release breakthrough in every dimension. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. And so, Lord, we thank you. God, take the worship of today. Lord, take the words that Shekinah spoke, that the testimony Kim gave, Lord, the word of the Lord in Scripture. And God, mix it together with faith in our hearts. God, as we go from this place, Lord, in the next few moments, that God, it would the word of the Lord would stir within us, would germinate within us, and God, it would come to fulfill all you sent your word to do. And God, we pray that you prepare us all for, Lord, what you want to do tonight. Lord, as we come back, and Lord, tonight take some time around these altars to lay hands, to speak prophetically, personally, as the Holy Spirit leads. So, God, we give you thanks and we give you praise in Jesus' name for your glory. Would you take a moment and just clap your hands and praise to the Lord with me? Lord, we honor you and we praise you. Guys, thank you for pressing in with us. 6:30 tonight. Come, we're going to have a little bit less talking time and some time around the altar, so it would be our privilege. We're not promising to give everybody a prophecy, but guys, what we want to do is just come, get into his presence, and allow the Lord to minister in that way. So thank you all so much. Worship team, thank you guys very much. Did you need to share anything before we go? Please.
Yes, everyone, remember tonight at 6:30, plus we will be having the business meeting next week with the dinner as planned.